Divine inspiration isn't that kind of communication. Divine inspiration is, for example, to feel, for reasons that you can't really understand, that you love people. Divine inspiration is a wisdom, which it's very difficult to put into words, like mystical experience. That's divine inspiration. And a person who writes out of that experience could be said to be divinely inspired. Since inspiration always comes through a human vehicle, it is liable to be distorted by that vehicle. In other words, I'm talking to you through a sound system, and it's the only one now available. Now, if there's something wrong with this sound system, whatever truths I might utter to you will be distorted, and you might mistake the meaning of what I said. Now, so therefore, everybody who receives divine inspiration will express it within the limits of what language he knows. And by language here, I don't only mean English, Latin, Greek, Hebrew, or Sanskrit. I mean language in the sense of what sort of terms are available to you. What kind of religion were you brought up with? Now, you don't have to be any particular kind of religion to get this experience. It can hit anyone, anytime, like falling in love. It's found all over the world. And when it hits you, you know it. Sometimes it comes after long practice of meditations and spiritual discipline. Sometimes it comes for no reason that anybody can determine. We say it's the grace of God. That there comes this overwhelming conviction that you have mistaken your identity. That what you thought, what I thought, was just old Alan Watts, who I know very well is just a big act and a show, was only completely superficial. That I am an expression of an eternal something or other, a name that can't be named, and that I suddenly understand why, exactly why everything is the way it is. It's perfectly clear. Furthermore, I feel no longer any boundary between what I do and what happens to me. I feel that everything is my doing just as my breathing is. Is your breathing voluntary or involuntary? Do you do it or does it happen to you? So you can feel it both ways, but you feel everything like breathing. And it isn't as if you had become a puppet. There is no longer any separate you. There is just this great happening. And if you have the name in your background, you will say, this happening is God, or the will of God, or the doing of God. Or if you don't have that word in your background, you will say with the Chinese, it is the flowing of the Tao. Or if you're a Hindu, you will say, it is the Maya of Brahman. The Maya means the magical power. The creative illusion, the play. So you can very well understand how people to whom this happens feel genuinely inspired, because very often there goes along with it an extremely warm feeling, because you see the divine in everybody else's eyes.